Welcome, Aretusa Novice. In this lesson, we're going to take a look at all the different play formats you will encounter in tournaments, as well as the most popular tournament advancement rules. For Gwent, the most important rule sets are single elimination, double elimination, and Swiss. So let's start with single elimination. That means that you face off an enemy one by one. Each series consists of multiple matches, and if you win 2 out of 3, or most of the time 3 out of 5, you win and advance to the next round. If you lose, you're out of the tournament. Double elimination is similar to single elimination, but you get another chance after losing a series because you join another single elimination roster, which consists of everyone who lost a match. In the finals, the winner of the loser and the winner roster will face off against each other for the tournament win. Swiss is another popular rule set, where each player plays a predefined number of games against random players in the tournament. You're not out after you lose a series, but in the end all players are sorted into a list according to their wins, and the player with the most accumulated wins wins the tournament. In Gwent, the Swiss rule set often is only one part of the tournament. The first day of the tournament is played in the Swiss rule set, and then the best 8 or 16 players advance to the second part of the tournament, where they will face off in a single elimination tournament. Now, let's take a look at play formats. They dictate what happens to your deck after you won or lost a match. In Gwent, Conquest is played in nearly every tournament, so we will spend a bit more time talking about that. Conquest means that you need to win with each of your decks to advance to the next round of the tournament. Therefore, as soon as you've won with one of your decks, you're not able to play it again until you face off against a new opponent in a new round. Your decisions of which decks you'll bring to the tournament matters a lot in this format, and it also matters when you decide to play each deck. You can make your life dramatically easier by trying to predict the enemy's deck choice for each match. The more you play in tournaments, the easier you will get a feel for these situations, enabling you to predict and break your opponent's strategy, so it's up to you to bring the scissors against the paper deck. Another format is Last Hero Standing, which is quite popular in Hearthstone. Instead of not being able to use a deck again after you've won with it, you are forced to keep playing with the deck until your opponent defeats it. Losing decks cannot be used again, and you have won the series when your opponent is out of decks to play. The last one is Blind Pick, where each player just picks a deck and plays it, regardless if you have already won or lost with that deck. This is sometimes played in casual tournaments, but even there, Conquest is taking over more and more. In the rules of each tournament, everything should be explained in great detail, but we hope that this video served as a good overview of the rules and formats. Continue with the other lessons about tournament play to learn how you can use the tournament's format in your favor by doing the correct picks and bans, choosing the right lineup, and many more tips.